Hello everybody, I hope everybody is fine. Today we'll be discussing about forensic ballistics and this first audio lecture is dedicated to introduction part. So let's start with the term ballistics. So first of all I'll be discussing about the term ballistics. So what is ballistics? Ballistics is basically the science that deals with the flight behavior and effect of a projectile. So in simple words I would like to say that the term ballistics was basically coined to study the trajectory and behavior of any projectile. So that projectile can be stone, bullets, missile. Now when we start associating the term forensic ballistics, obviously in forensics we try to study those things where a crime has been committed, and we want to use the knowledge of ballistics or physics or any other thing to identify the culprit who committed the crime. So forensic ballistics can be defined as the science of analyzing firearms, bullets and bullet impact. In forensic ballistics we basically study the firearms, because in most of the cases where a person has been killed, if a bullet has been used, then obviously we want to identify which type of firearm was used, who was in possession of that particular firearm. So all these things are studied in forensic ballistics. And the major part of forensic ballistics is firearms identification. So it can be considered as a sub-discipline of ballistics, where we want to determine whether a particular bullet or the cartridge that was found at the crime scene was fired from a particular weapon or not. And by identifying the particular weapon, we can identify the person who fired that particular weapon, or we can also narrow down the list of suspected people. Then ballistics is divided into three different phases or parts. Internal ballistics is there, external ballistics is there, terminal ballistics is there. Now, internal means the things which are happening inside the firearm. So it will be basically concerned with the things that takes place inside the firearm, the charge which is ignited inside the firearm, and when the particular projectile leaves the muzzle. So muzzle is basically a part of the firearm, the end of the firearm from where the bullet comes out. And here we are talking about the bullet if we are discussing the term projectile. Then there is external ballistics. So it deals with the motion of the projectile the moment it is outside the muzzle end and it is in the air, and the moment it is going to target the going to reach the target. In this case it can be a person. Then there is terminal ballistics. It deals with the motion of the projectile and the parts of the fragments. So basically when a bullet has impacted the person, so what were the different effects that happened on the person, that thing will be discussed in terminal ballistics. Now here I would like to discuss that the science of ballistics was basically developed to facilitate the examination of firearms, ammunition and other related matter. But the term ballistics is generally used to refer to the study of the trajectory of bullets or missiles. And the father of forensic ballistics is basically called Colonel Goddard, and he was the one who coined the phrase forensic ballistics. So now in forensic ballistics we basically deals with the firearms, ammunition. So the question arises, what is firearm? Now firearm is basically any instrument or device that discharges a missile or projectile by the expansion of gaseous forces. So basically certain gases are formed inside the barrel which basically push the bullet outside the barrel. So here what happens inside the barrel is potential energy is converted into kinetic energy, and which ultimately leads to the movement of the bullet outside the barrel. Now let's discuss what are the different categories of firearms. Since we are dealing with the firearms, so there must be certain categories of firearms which we will be studying again and again, which we will be discussing in the forensic ballistics. Now here I have categorized three types of firearms. So those three categories are handguns, long guns, mounted guns. Now from the term itself, it's clear that handguns will be the one which are easier to carry in hand. So it includes pistols, revolvers, derringers. Long guns include rifles, shotgun. Mounted guns means which need a particular space to be set up. So it includes cannons, aircraft guns. Now since we have discussed the different categories of firearms, we should move on to the different parts which are there in a handgun. Now the picture here I have put is of single action revolver and semi-automatic pistol. Now you can see there is muzzle end, then there is ejector rod, barrel is there, this long cylindrical thing is barrel, then there is cylinder, then there is trigger guard, trigger is there, hammer is there. So these are the parts of a single action revolver. Now the firearms are also categorized on the basis of action. So this thing will be discussed in the next part of the audio lecture. In this particular audio lecture, I'm just trying to give a brief introduction of the things which we'll be dealing in forensic ballistics. So the major parts that play an important role in a firearm are muzzle, barrel, ejector rod, trigger. Then there is caliber. So caliber is basically present inside the firearm, and that is another term that will be discussed, which will be discussed in the next audio lecture. So here I would like to revise the certain concepts which I have discussed in the audio lecture. First of all, the term ballistics. So ballistics is the science of projectile motion, and it has came from a Greek word balen, which means to throw. And forensic ballistics is the science which deals with the investigation of firearms, ammunitions, and the problems arising from their use. And ballistics has been subdivided into three parts: external ballistics, terminal ballistics, and wound ballistics. So if you have any problem in any of these concepts, you can put your comments in the comment section. We'll get back to you. And if you want us to elaborate more regarding internal ballistics, terminal ballistics, then you can also put that thing in the comment section. Thank you.